Let's take a look at building a set of the Headamame headphones. These are a really popular kit. You get all of the hardware, the drivers, everything you need except for 3D printed parts. And printing those parts gives you a lot of flexibility as far as the look of your headphones, as well as being able to tweak how they sound. So I'm going to start off talking through some of your options, and then we're actually going to build a set of these. So the first thing to do is there are a couple of parts that we need to take a look at. This is the headband spring. This is the part that actually holds the headphones onto your head. This is the spring clamp. This holds the spring onto the cups of the headphone. And this is the headband mount. So this is the opposite side of this that will hold the headband in place. These three parts need to be printed from something that will not deform with pressure over time. So PETG at a minimum, but you might want to consider using ASA or ABS if your printer can handle it. The other main part of the headphones are these pieces, which are called cones, which you can print out of anything. These could be PLA, so if you've got some sort of color changing or, you know, super sparkly or whatever, you can use PLA for those parts, but just be aware, like with everything with PLA, that material is a little sensitive to heat. So if you forgot these in your car, they might be a little warped when you come back to them. Speaking of the cones, there are two options provided in the models. So your options for the cones are closed back and open back. A closed back headphone has the speaker driver completely enclosed behind it. So this area that goes over your ear is going to help block any noise that's happening around you. So these are great if you're using them in a noisy environment, using them on public transportation. That will really make it easier for you to hear your music versus hearing the noise around you. The other design is open back, where there is not a closed volume behind your ear. Many people feel that an open backed headphone is more immersive. You have a wider sound stage. The downside of an open back headphone is not only can you hear more of what's happening around you, so you're going to hear that noise that's in your environment. People that are around you are also going to be able to hear the music that you're listening to. So again, it's a personal choice whether you prefer open or closed back headphones. And it only takes a couple hours to print these. So you could even try and do both designs and see which you prefer. I'm going to do the open back, and that has the advantage of also looking pretty wild because these parts use a gyroid infill. And there's ways that you slice this so that there's no walls on that infill. And that will let the sound basically escape out from the back sides of the drivers and not be trapped inside an enclosed volume of the headphone cup. So once you've made all of your decisions about whether you want open or closed back and what materials you want to use, just get those printed, and now we'll take a look at how this all goes together. The kit is going to include the two headphone drivers, ear pads, all the hardware, all of the wiring that you need, as well as a microphone so that you can use this as a headset either for meetings or for gaming. So let's get started by installing the headphone cable jacks. So you'll notice that there are two different jacks. One has two wires, one has four wires. As the kit is provided, the four wire is for the right side. So we're going to take the left wire, and you can see this has a flat on it, and there is also a flat in the cone. So I'm going to make sure those are lined up. And now we need to press that into the cone. And you can just press that on the table to get that in place. So there's that one done. The connectors for the headphone cables go in from the outside. Set that one aside. Now the cone for the right-hand side has a headphone connector as well as the microphone connector. So again, we'll start with the headphone connector. Get this started. Once that's in, we just push that and that's seated. Now this connector, which is for the removable headset, goes in from the inside. So we'll just get that. Started in there. If you need a little bit of help, you can take a tool or something and press on this white part of that connector, but mine's seated pretty easily. So there's that done. Before I forget, we also have these clips that we need to print, and those go in these slots to hold the headphone connectors in place. And once you get that in as much as you can by hand, you can just press down on the table to seat that connector. So let's build a headphone. Going to start by mounting the headphone into this flange. Now, the headphone goes on this side, the smooth side, because this ring is a mount for the ear pad. So we're going to put that in there. Now let's take a look at the orientation. This is marked as top. What I'm going to do is turn this so that the cables are pointing down. The other thing I've done is I'm going to mount this. If you can see the printed mount for the speaker has a slope to it. I'm going to mount this so that the thicker part is going to be to the front, so that when you put the headphones on, it's going to match the curvature of my ear. So the first thing I need to do is I'm going to put these screws in the bottom two holes, because we're going to build the bottom first. And this isn't actually threading, it's just a very kind of tight interference fit. So next we're going to take the cone for the bottom, which has the connector, and let's get those screws through here. And again, this isn't actually a threaded feature. They just need a little help getting through. You can hear that, you know, those are just, that's just spinning in there. Okay, so now we have the driver mounted there. We're going to connect red to red and black to black. So make sure that that is correct so that the phase of the driver will be correct. And you want to kind of move that off to the side, because there's going to be a screw coming through here and you don't want it to go into that part. So with that done, I'm going to take this. And now this does have holes on the bottom for these screws. So we're going to thread those screws into this part. Don't over tighten because you're tightening a screw directly into plastic. You don't want it to strip. So let me So you're just going to alternate tightening this down. And I wouldn't tighten it all the way at this point because we've still got a little more to do, but get it pretty close. Now you need to take your band, and the band slides over. Oh, actually, what would be good before we did that is to just empty that out. Take this little stopper. Oh, come on, focus. And that gets threaded into the center hole because this is what tensions the strap. Going to start that by hand. I'm going to support that under there, and then they give you this handy little tool that we can use to get that jammer in there. And when you're done, the rubber should be flush against that piece there. So now we're going to take this and fit it over. There are slots in there. So it seats like that. Now we're going to take the top cone and fit it It's a little fiddly because there is some tension there. Just work slowly and carefully. And now with that fitted, I will go ahead and put the last two screws in. All right. So now let's take a look at putting on our ear pads. So there is kind of a gap there that goes here, and what we do is take this cutout, hook it there, and then just turn and keep turning, and then that will magically pop into place. And now we have a headphone, and I went ahead and built the right side, which assembled the same as the left. And again, we're going to hook that and just turn, and there we go. So the headphones themselves are complete. Now we have to deal with the strap. So the kit comes with this leather band, and we have these clamp pieces. There are two sets of holes. So you have some adjustment as to how tight you want these to be on your head. And what I'm going to do is, you can see these are printed with holes already. So I'm going to do my best to match up those holes with the holes in the strap, just to make things easy. easier. So what I'm going to do is this piece goes on the outside. This piece will go on the inside. The screws go through there. And the way this works, so I will put screws through. I'll at least start them. So this is going to trap that band. And you're not going to see these screws because they'll be covered by the strap. And then what you do is line up the holes in the leather. And I'm saying leather, I'm not sure if it's an actual leather or some other kind of product. Get the whole screws through there. And then we're going to screw these together. And same warning applies. Don't over tighten, but get it just tight enough. So there's one side done, and the way this works is this actually will go up that way. So now I'm going to repeat. Okay, so there is our headband done. And now the only thing that's left is we will take the headphone. We slide this through. Like so. And the other side. So I've got same amount on each side. Now, here is the little boom microphone. So we'll plug the microphone in. And then finally, we have out of the way our cable assembly. Very nice cloth covered braiding on the outside. The cable goes to a standard 4-conductor eighth inch connector that will work with most laptops or phones. And then we have our left, see if I can get this. We have our left and right plugs. So we'll just get those plugged in. And with that, our headphones are built. Nothing left but to plug them in and see how they sound. So I've spent some time listening to music through these headphones. They have an amazing bass response. There's a lot going on there, even with the open back design. I've also tested the microphone and confirmed that that works as a standard input, so you can use that for gaming or for meetings.
I'm stuck in a Zoom meeting, but at least I have a funky headset.
So I hope you enjoyed seeing how these headphones go together, and I hope that this encourages you to go out and do a project of your own.